Now, a film depicting the plight of refugees is being screened across the UK. In Another Life is a British independent film shot from the perspective of refugees arriving in France. It follows a man from Syria who's trapped in the infamous jungle, the refugee camp in Calais, who, with his friend, tries to get to England. Let's have a look.
Say this city has 10 million souls. Some are living in mansions. Some are living in holes. Yet there is no place for us, my dear. Yet there is no place for us.
You've been saying the same thing on and on. Yousef, my family is going to send me this, my family is going to send them that. The money never comes.
So that was a little section from In Another Life, and we're joined by some of the actors that you saw in that trailer, Yousef Jubeh and Adam Wittek. Thank you very much for joining us here on Newsday. This is a film that talks about the plight of refugees from the perspective, from the first-hand perspective of refugees. Yousef, your character, also called Yousef, you're best friends with another character, and you are. We know so much about you as a character through this film. It really humanises the story of all of those people who are in such dire conditions.
Right, yeah. I mean, initially when we first went out there, in order for us to understand their stories, we ended up hanging out with them essentially for 5 days before we started shooting. And to me, what was most important is to know who they are as people rather than refugees. To help me understand who they are. And one thing that really struck me the most is how normal they are, how, you know, they're just like me and you, but they happen to be in this situation.
So it's interesting to stress that the way it was filmed, you actually went into the jungle and you were filming there.
Right, yeah, so we did it in three stages. The first 2 weeks, well, the first stage, we went out there for 2 weeks, we filmed in Calais, came back after 6 months, shot in Warrington up north, where we reconstructed the jungle. And then 2 weeks later, we went out there again to finish it off, basically.
Wow, so a long process. Adam, your character is slightly different. Mm. You play one of the people traffickers. We very rarely hear the perspective, that type of perspective. How do you get into that role?
Well, unlike Yousef, I didn't have a chance to speak to the traffickers and do my research that way, because it was sometimes we had a bit of dangerous situations there that they obviously didn't want to be filmed or talked to. So I then just did a lot of online research and basically just try to find a way of what do they actually want. It's basically for them a business. It's a business with human lives, and so very much you then that try to make that your focus, because you don't really care about the lives that are behind the refugees that are staying there.
In terms of the actors, because of course you are professional actors, you had refugees playing characters there. Tell me a little bit about one of the characters, Mima.
Mima is from Eritrea. He migrated all the way and was stuck in Cali for almost a year. He was the first person we actually met in the jungle. We ended up filming with him in the first part, not expecting him to be in the rest of the film. And just before we started shooting the second leg in North England, he ended up calling Jason Wingard, the director, and Jason invited him on the set, and this is where we continued the story with Mima.
And it's very much his story, because it wasn't, you had a plot, but it wasn't scripted, and some of Mima's dialogue is improvised.
Is improvised, that's correct. So we try to be as real as possible in the film, and Mima has, as a refugee, he has experienced some really horrific things. And so everything basically that he talks about in the film are his real stories, are his real experiences, which when you watch the film, you think it is scripted, but it is very real, and therefore very, very moving and touching to know that this is what the people are really going through.
You've had a lot of success in the film festivals. You've had rave reviews. What do you hope that this film will achieve?
I think ultimately it's just to shred a light on who these people are. they are like many of us who happen to be in this situation. You know, it could happen to anyone. And it's just, you know, just to remind people that it is a problem that is happening and it will happen again in the future. But we also need to remember that they are the same as us. But they're, you know, in this situation, unfortunately.
And just last week, of course, we saw tensions once again arise in Calais with various different groups of fighting and shots being fired. Of course, this is still ongoing, even though the jungle, the infamous jungle that you captured so well in the film, has been dismantled. The problem's still there.
It is. So, I mean, there have been, I think in the last month, in the last 2 months, there have been even a couple of deaths again, unfortunately, which is very tragic. But that is still the reality in Calais. And it doesn't help to just demolish the camp. Because just if you tear down the tents, the refugees are still coming there. It is like closing your eyes and turning the other way. It doesn't solve the problem. It just bypasses it or you avoid it rather than actually tackling and solving it. And that is, I think, what the film tries to shed a light on. Then we need to solve it and approach it rather than turning the other
way. Absolutely. Well, we could discuss this for much longer, but Adam Wittek, Yousef Jubeh, thank you so much in Another Life screening in the UK. And thank you very much for watching Newsday. Bye-bye.